For the final part, let's look at typical WLAN networking solutions. First, we'll discuss large-scale WLAN deployment. We divide it into access, aggregation, core, and exit layers. This is also the case in wired networks. However, wireless networks are actually quite simple. Just hang an AC at the core or aggregation layer. Then connect a few APs at the access layer. And at this point, the wireless network merges into our wired network. It's very simple. Next, let's look at the agile distributed solution. You could say it's an architecture, or you could say it's not an architecture, because it still relies on the AC plus thin AP architecture. It actually evolved from indoor distributed APs. What are the features of this agile distributed solution? It breaks traditional APS into a central AP and remote units, or RUS, two separate devices. The central AP can be deployed in server rooms, telecom closets, and corridors. Remote units can be installed directly in rooms via cables passing through walls, allowing each room to enjoy high-quality wireless access. These remote units differ from traditional APs. They do not consume licenses, and not consuming licenses means saving money. This solution is typically deployed in dormitories, hotels, hospital rooms, and other room-dense environments. Thus, the central AP can be deployed in server rooms, telecom closets, or even corridors. Note here, the connection between the central AP and the remote units is not via coaxial cable. It uses Ethernet cables, which are generally not recommended to exceed 80 meters. So, this solution enjoys the performance of panel APS for the cost of just one license. It's simple to manage, flexible to deploy, covers without dead zones, and offers long-range coverage. Its coverage distance is determined by the central AP, generally within 100 meters. The last two plans, the micro chain store plan and the small to medium-sized chain store plan, are both solved through cloud management solutions. Just get to know about this. In this chapter, we primarily introduced the basic concepts of WLAN, various WLAN networking architectures, including fat AP architecture, AC plus thin AP architecture, cloud management architecture, leader AP architecture, and intelligent campus network architecture. We need to learn the networking methods and forwarding models within the AC plus thin AP architecture. Finally, we introduce several typical application scenarios. This part covers the WLAN networking model. In the next lesson, I will explain the working principles of WLAN. Thank you, everyone. See you in the next class.